Gestational diabetes is a type of diabetes that appears during pregnancy. So it's not there before you get pregnant. We think it's possibly because the body can't make enough insulin to cope with the extra demands of pregnancy. We usually see gestational diabetes developing in the second or third trimester of your pregnancy, and that's after your baby's vital organs have all been developed, so it's not going to cause damage to your baby's development in that way.
Well, my pregnancy was normal, everything was fine, I was really enjoying it. Obviously I had the first 3 months where I was a bit sicky, and everything seemed to be going really, really well. And then I had a number of midwife checks and my glucose in my urine was slightly high.
So when you go to see your midwife at your booking interview, she will actually go through some of the risk factors. And if you have any one of them, you'll be offered a special blood test, which will see whether your blood glucose level is too high.
I suddenly started to notice that I'd go to a yoga group and everyone was either further down the line than I was, or the same kind of stage of pregnancy that I was, but I was larger than everyone else and I just started to really, really grow. And I spoke to my midwife about it, who measured me and said that I actually was bigger than I should be, and again, I had glucose in the urine. So she sent me off to see an obstetrician, who then sent me off for a growth scan. And they spotted that the baby's abdominal circumference was larger than it should be, which is another indicator for gestational diabetes.
The risk factors for developing gestational diabetes are a body mass index of over 30, a previous very large infant weighing over 4.5 kilograms, about 9.5 pounds. Another risk factor is having had a pregnancy when you had gestational diabetes, having a close family member with diabetes, or for being from the ethnic minority groups of the South Asian population, the Black African Caribbean population, or the Middle Eastern population. For your baby, the biggest problem is that if your blood glucose levels are high, that will pass across the placenta and go to your baby. That extra glucose that your body's producing for your baby could cause it to grow big. We use the term macrosomia. And when you come to have the baby, it could either cause problems as you're giving birth by actually damaging its shoulder as the baby passes through the birth canal, or you may have to have a cesarean section delivery. And what we want is to get you to have the very best, most natural delivery with the best outcomes. If you're diagnosed with gestational diabetes, the first advice that you'll be given is to try and improve your eating pattern. Extra physical activity is really, really important.
I went to see a dietitian who looked at my diet. You know, it was quite healthy, but I suddenly realised, although I don't eat, or I don't think I eat lots of sugar, at breakfast time I was eating, you know, oats or cereal with fruit, maybe with fruit juice. And together, that is a big hit of sugar. So we looked at kind of reducing my portions and spacing things out. I went on the internet actually and printed off a list of the GI values in food and had it on the fridge. And it's a surprising, you know, plain chocolate, it has far lower glucose in it than a watermelon. So it's really surprising. And the way you cook certain foods can, you know, affect the glucose levels in it. So it really is, the first few days was really a kind of a minefield of eating something, realizing, oh, can't eat that again.
If this doesn't have any effect, and in a short time, over 1 to 2 weeks, then your doctor will suggest you might go on to tablets, which will help the insulin that you're producing be effective and bring your blood glucose levels down. And some women do actually need to have insulin injections, because it's really, really important for both your health and the health of your baby that your blood glucose levels are as near to normal as possible.
I didn't have treatment as such. I was told to monitor my blood for the first couple of days, watch my diet. I spoke to the dietitian, and I called in the results and spoke to the nurse, and she was really happy with my blood levels. So it was a case of, if I can manage my blood sugar levels, I didn't have to have insulin.
Most women who have gestational diabetes find it goes away once the baby's born. Before you leave hospital to go back into the care of your doctor in the community, your blood sugar will be checked to make sure of that. And then it's really, really important that you go to your 6-week postnatal appointment because you'll be checked again. There are some women who still have diabetes at that 6-week appointment, and this shows that they were probably developing diabetes anyway, but the pregnancy just brought it out. The biggest worry for somebody who has had gestational diabetes is that it puts you at much, much higher risk of developing type 2 diabetes as you grow older.
The support I had was brilliant. The nurses were great. I had regular checkups. I was always at the hospital. There were always other women around me. It kind of made me realise that, you know, it happens a lot and it's over and done with so quickly.
Your healthcare team will be able to spot problems occurring before they get too bad. And so keep in close touch with them, turn up for your appointments and enjoy your pregnancy.